Hello, everybody. Another week and another time to make progress. So, I've actually fixed the whole filter bullshit that took me actually way too long, but it was actually pretty fun to learn and pretty fun to experiment with. So let me see. As promised, let's walk through the Let me turn down my music just a little teeny tiny bit. I still want to hear something. Don't worry, it won't affect you. It only affects my my in-ears. Okay, so how did I end up fixing the filters? Well, we had to get rid of all the generate static pages. So we went from static page generation to server-side rendering, which isn't all that bad. Because it's pretty, I don't know, the refactor wasn't all that difficult. But from there, I still had to make all the required changes, because once it started working, I of course ran into a lot of bugs. So I actually spent, I think I spent like 2 or 3 hours this morning. I didn't get around to it last week. Friday was busy, Saturday was busy, Sunday I was hangover and busy. If you know where I was like last Thursday, know that from there between now it took me around let's see toggle for the exact number. It took me precisely 3 hours. It took me precisely 3 hours to let me quickly update one of my to-dos. So it's today. Yeah. So this thing took me 3 hours to complete. So let's see, what did we do? Okay, so this file change, let me increase it for you all. So this file change was, I implemented a better way to clear the filters. Normally I would just route to the homepage, but that wasn't sufficient now that we use query parameters. Because then if you route from the categories page to the homepage, what happened when you cleared filters on the category page? While the parameters would get removed, the filters would still be like filled with a value because the state didn't reset. So instead of doing all kinds of things in like the listing file or in the context, I was just like, okay, let's just move everything to the context. So we have a clear filters function now where we reset the state and then we route to the homepage. Or the category page, if you're on the category page, and we just say, okay, remove the queries, query parameters, or we link you to the homepage without the query parameters. So you have a nice clean URL. Also, instead of like talking about it way too long, or not instead, but you might want to see how it actually works. So, as you can see, we have this. So let's say we go to, I know e-commerce is a big category. So Amazon is now on top, because this is something you have to remember. We haven't started this yet. We are going to do this today. This is a sponsored row. So also implemented the SOAR thing and the API like logic for the is sponsored row, because I think, okay, while I'm at it, why not just implement it so I don't encounter any surprises later on. So now we can say, okay, maybe we want to have an e-commerce based on credits. I don't know if that's, yeah, we have Shopify, which lets you earn credit for some reason, but I know it's monthly, so I have to change that. And let's say if we take monthly, so we only get back the monthly programs. This is all e-commerce, not a single credit, not a single thing. And now we see, okay, so we have the 1 day, no cookie, 10 days, 14 days. So I can say, okay, do descending. And now you notice that Amazon stays on top, and that might not make any sense, but I want the sponsored row to stay on top. Because if people share this URL with like someone else and they go here, I don't want sponsors to get confused. And I think it's pretty obvious that if you have sponsored row, it will always show on top. Because otherwise, I can already imagine all the support tickets, or if I even get any customers at all, of course. I hope so. But if links are shared internally with like sponsors, and they see like their program is not on top, even though the filter set, they're going to be fuming. And I think sponsored rows should always be on top, regardless of the filter, if you pay for a sponsorship on the category page. So instead of only showing sponsored here, we might have to give it an orange outline to extract a little bit more from the rest of the listing. But hey, we'll figure that out today. So now the fun stuff is, if I go back to the homepage, the category will be set to null. And everything will be shown. So you see that the query parameters are all gone. Now, what else do we want to show? Well, we could say that we want to filter the entire homepage on, do we have any multiple payment times? Yeah, we have eBay. Any monthly, any descending. Then I can go to like, let's go to e-commerce again. And then that will all stay the same. So in 19 days, 30 days, 14 days. So everything checks out. And then we can clear the filter and we'll get sent back to the homepage. That took a couple of, maybe 1 to 2 seconds because the server side rendered. So one thing we also have to do is look at caching. I mean, we'll have to wait and see how fast everything is once we deploy it, because I'm actually kind of curious how fast it's going to be with server-side rendering as opposed to static. You know, the time to first byte is always going to be faster with statically generated pages. But since we wanted to use the query parameters, we have to use server-side props. And I guess that's fine, because most of the things come from the server, and it doesn't make any sense to really statically generate these pages. And using these server-side render methods is also great for SEO, because the browser will also get back a fully static page with the initial data. So all is good, all is well. So let's see. So I implemented the clear filters. Then you can see that I added a parameter to all the update payment, update category, and update cookie period for set default. That's because in the index page, if you, I don't know, for the first time come to a page, you want to let everything know. Okay, if we update the payment types, we don't want to do any router pushes. We just want to set the default. So just want to set the payment type and don't do any routing. That only needs to happen if it's not a set default, it's like a regular update. This is what we did last week, so nothing really changed except for the set default and the clear filter in this file. Last we covered last week. So we have shallow, which means don't refetch the page, but only add the query parameters. Now, the use infinite has been updated, because what I'm doing here is we are going to extract the query params. Then I'm using this nifty little function to create a param string. So we don't have to do question mark, category, and then end sign with like the cookie period, or make a whole if else statement. Now, if you use this form, basically this function takes care of setting up an object for like the URL params, and then if category is there, it will add the category. If the category payment is in, it will add the category, an end sign, and then the payment type. If there are no params, it will just return no params. It will just return an empty string. And that's nice, because now this is way more easy to understand, and you only have to worry about this and not so much more about this. Then we, instead of has cookie, we change this cookie period. So in the database, I think that makes a lot more sense. Then if we go to get programs, I update default filters to let filters, because we can't use this. we can't use this in Notion because otherwise it will return null, or I don't know, I couldn't get it to work. I don't remember the exact error message, but I think Notion API was always complaining about yada 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 can be undefined. It has to be a value of string. So I was like, okay, how can I fix that? I think, okay, I can just make an array because Notion wants wants an array down here for the select. Excuse me, where is it? Oh yeah, it's here. So for the end and the sorts, it wants an array and then all the property objects where you can sort on. So let's see, where was I? So for the let filters, we set like the basic array with the default values, and then we say, okay, if there's category, in this case for the filters, add or push this object to the filters, and then at the end return the filter. Same for payment type, same for resolve sorts, where if you're on the home, if it's a category page, you want to get back the sponsored categories. So we added, we split the sponsored column into two separate columns, like a sponsor for category, sponsor for home. They can both be true, but you don't fetch the is sponsored home on the category pages, right? And then last but not least, we sort on cookie period. So why the double sort? Because on the first sort, it's actually giving importance to the is sponsored category, and that's important to me because I always want to show the sponsored rows first, and then it will sort everything else on, or basically that array on cookie period. So is sponsored is more important. So then we have this here, so resolve filters and resolve sorts. Then let's see, we have the get program function, which we updated just a little bit. I think it's also better for the home. Did things change really all that much? Yeah, so here you see why I added the default category, and it only happens on mount. So for the set the current payment type and current cook period, which is important if you first render the page. Then on the category page, we pretty much did all the same. You see that the same logic with the true, with the current payment type, the current cookie type. Okay, so because we got rid of the get static paths, we had to do a check to see if the category that the user links to is actually, so let's remove this. So if you go to program paths, which is a category, it works. But we also need to throw a 404 page if someone tries to look up a page that just doesn't exist in our database. Get static paths took care of that. So since we moved to get server side props, we have to do that ourselves, which I did with this nifty little array.sum or categories.data.sum, which checks, okay, we already have the categories here because we have to move past that to our select, to our filters. And here we say, okay, if look at all the categories dot names and see if our parameter category is in here. So our, if we go to, I don't know, weddings, I don't think we have any wedding stuff, but if this value is in the category, say we want to render a page because that category is always available. It may well have no data, but it is available. However, if I go to weddings, for, I don't know, for Jedis, that's not a category, and that probably will never be a category. So we throw 404, which in next pretty easy. You just say return an object with not found true. We have to remove the revalidate function because that's only available with static props. And we added the current payment type and the current cookie period. So all we basically need to have to do to fully have like moved over from statically generated pages to like server-side props is to implement caching, which we'll do eventually. So let's get cracking, shall we? Because today, also let's zoom out before my GitHub is like set to zoom function grandmother. For eternity, Let's move this to the side and oh, that's me. And let's see what we want to do today. So I'm very lacking behind with the update database stuff. I don't know, for some reason I'm busy at the moment with all kind of other stuff. So this is a real blocker. So I already planned in time like tomorrow morning and the morning afterwards. Actually, I planned in time this morning until I realized, oh shit, I have to do the whole filtering thing. And that, of course, took more hours than expected. So hopefully I can get the update database done by the week, by the end of the week. And then next week we can do the whole bunch stuff. Or maybe we'll finish most of the app today or tomorrow and then Thursday and Friday we can do most of the launch stuff. Maybe next stream on Friday, I don't know. No promises. So let's see. What should we do now? Okay, update no row message. These are actually a couple of like things I discovered while working on the filters. I was like, okay, when let's go to Okay, let's go to pets. One sec. I'm almost cured from that horrible flu / cough, but my throat is still a little sore. But let's see. Okay, we know that we have payment type monthly in here, but if I select like multiple credits, we don't have any affiliate programs based on these criteria. If you want to be the first, please submit your program. Inside here, I also want to add a quick button to like or clear your filters. And then they can clear the filters and see all for category pets, right? I don't think it's like the most used feature ever, but but I think it's pretty handy to have there, and it's pretty easy to like implement. And maybe we can extend the clear filters with like clear all, clear payment type, clear cookie period, because if we're on the category page, we only want to clear payment type and cookie period and not like clear category. So let's take care of that. So listing. Ooh, it's getting kind of hot in here with streaming. Shining through my windows on the floor, warming up my apartment. So I might just put on a t-shirt in a couple of minutes. But let's first write some code. So I can close my terminal because this is mostly going to be like front-end shizzle. So let's see, here's the message. So what we can do maybe is please submit your thingy, and then below here we might set like clear filters. Let's just first do the functionality. Also let's add a margin top of, I don't know, 6. That has to be class name, of course. And then we have clear filter, so on clickerino let's say clear the filters. So if I click on this now, the category, the payment type and the cookie period will all be cleared. Let's see. Okay, so that works. So let's say that if we go to the context, where is it? Maybe we can pass in from category, and then we can say if not from category, set to this. Okay, so that's all set. And then we also have to do if not from category, if from category, excuse me. No, I guess I don't have to set this. Does that make sense? Okay, so here's a, do we yeah, so this basically takes care of like, okay, so if we're on the category page and this is hit. Uh-huh. will From Category be a good name? No, I don't think so, because this click is also from category, and then you want to clear all filters. Maybe we can say omit category. I think that's better, like omit category. Like, don't do anything with category. So if we have omit category, let's move this up, that's fine. And if we do omit category, we can still do router push this, and then we can say category. Do we have any category thingy set? I think we can just say categories category, right? Okay, so let's go to pets. Let's go to pets. And let's say we do multiple, which isn't there, and we say this. The provided href yada yada category is missing query values. Oh no, that's true. So basically we need to have like another, I mean, I can also do this, like slash programs slash, can you do a router push next? Yes, router push with next. Yes, router push only update query params. Yeah. So we can do shallow true, which is going to be like great. I think that needs to be there, right? Yada yada yada. Okay, so we have path name. This is all like in anything. Then we have undefined, and then we have shallow true. So let's see. Interesting. Let me change this, because that's, let's stay consistent. I mean, both work, but I want to stay consistent. So route path name. Okay, so that's like this. So let's save this, because if we now go to the home page and we do like multiple and ascending, and we say clear, it works. And then here we also don't have to do a reload, so we can say undefined and shallow. So let's prevent that reload. So if I reload now, we still have category. Interesting. And why exactly do we have category is like nada. Let's remove this. Maybe it's just a mistake on my side that I didn't notice. Okay, so we have like credits, and we have like descending. And if I now do clear filters, it will route me back to the... Huh, why does it still say like categories question mark? I think router path name is this. So I guess we are here. So let's do he. Now I still didn't know. Let's do this. Let's say prefer reserve log. navigated to category yada. Huh. Yeah, so basically we are here, but that doesn't make any sense. If omit category, so omit category shouldn't be true at all here. If I like try to clear the filter from the, I mean, it doesn't have this parameter. So what's the matter, baby? Oh fuck. Why is that? That's odd. Is that because I didn't use an arrow function inside the onClick? I guess so. Otherwise, it's just getting all the parameters. But let's do this. Now let's clear. And now it still gets category. Tell me why. Why is it still getting the click event? I am confused. Oh, god damn it, sorry. I updated the wrong thing, fool. I should have updated this little thing. Where are you, my friend? Select, 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 select. Clear filter is clear filter. Oh shit, I took the whole on click, which is fine. Which is fine. Navigated to this, do credits. Yeah. Okay, cool. Now it works. Makes sense. My teeny tiny brain just is. I don't know. I'm still a little hungover from the weekend. I haven't drank that much beer and ate that much bad food in, like, I guess 2 years? I guess. Well, no, we had New Year's Eve, of course. That was horrible as well. I don't know. Give my brain until like the end of the week, and then I'm like, still not a genius, but maybe a little brighter. Okay, so now we're here. We can say, what a pet name. Okay, so this is all bueno. But now I'm still not sure why the whole page is reloading if I say, like, router push path name shallow. If I do this, okay, see, no reload. That's exactly what we want. And I guess we also want to do that on the category page. So if we now go to the category page, so now, interesting. How are we actually going to determine that we are on the category page? Huh? Are we going to pass along the category? I guess. Yeah, I mean, I think we can just set this to true, because what's the worst that can happen? I mean, if you're on the homepage and you try to omit the category and you set that to true, then we have a problem, because you have this, but that's fine, because here we already say, like, router path name. Set category is okay. Don't set category with also fine. Also fine. Also fine. And I don't think we'll actually actually see the clear message, but let's just check this. So we're on pets. We say we have multiple. We say clear filters. We only clear the payment type filter. And now we get to. Okay, and why is that? Because we forgot to include category. We need to euro encode that. Let's do that just to be sure. Or let's not do that and check like winnings and or there's in one category of beauty and I don't know exactly how it's called anymore. Let's get rid of the preserve log because that's driving me nuts. Okay, so we have pets and we can say multiple and we know that's not in there. Maybe we have to save the freaking thing, otherwise still not going to work. Pets yes, aborted. Am I retarded? What just happened? Let's refresh yet one yet again. Okay, so we have this. So this is set to true. So if we set we also don't have any credit, that's fine. So okay, so this is set to true. This is saved. So this then goes to like here. We say if we do if we don't have an omit category, set this to nothing, because that's what we want. Now, if the router path name is this, which isn't true on this page, it will go to here. Now it will route to like. Or is this actually true for some reason? Maybe that's the problem. That's not a problem. What's actually the problem is that with my good behavior, I forgot that we use this pattern, which says that you have to define the freaking pet name. And then we can go to pets. And then you will see that the computer still hates me and throws another bug at me, but one thing at a time. Okay. Why do you go to category? Interesting. Because don't have an undefined here. So that's the case because you shouldn't be reloading as well. We'll get there, we'll get there. I'm just doing things a little bit too fast as always. Huh. Click clear filters. This isn't a link, right? We don't have to add any query parameter here because category isn't param. Don't we have anything in that category? That can also be the case. Where's the category? Where's the pets category? No, that doesn't have any credits. So if you now clear the filters, yeah, boy, that works. So if descending, that will always work, but let's just check it again. Clear filters, yada bing yada boom, which is not the correct pronunciation of that saying, but I'm Dutch, so smooch. Okay, cool. I was getting tired of all these bugs that took me like 4 hours on stream, and then once I slept on it like 10 minutes or 3 hours in this case, but tomorrow was a bit of a big bug. Okay, so we have this working now. Cool. Now, does it also work on the homepage? I don't think we have anything. Okay, so let's open our database. Let's simulate this because we only have one multiple in here. So let's change that to monthly and then change it back just to see if it works on the homepage. Use affiliates. Multiple. Let's change this to monthly and let's remember which one that is. So let's this is cache. Okay, so clear filter goes back to home. Nice. So multiple, even with ascending, clear filters. Nice. Okay, so credits, descending, clear filters, back to homepage. So even with pets. And like multiple and ascending, we do this, we get sent back to the homepage. Yep, okay, so that is great. Let's set it back to multiple. Okay, first thing of the stream, not the day, first thing of the stream, down. Let's go to product, use affiliates. We were working on this, when filters are selected, we can, actually, I don't think we're done here. I don't think we're done here. Because if we go here, this doesn't look like a button. So let's fix that. What should we do? Do we want to give this the same as this? Do we want to make this an orange button? Let's see. Let's give this a PX light off. 2 PY of 2 and this a PP, and let's give this a background of primary. Maybe we want to give it a background of black. I think that works better. I think that works better, and then text white. Or what do you guys think? Let me give this a rounded and a shadow. Do we have a shadow button? We have a shadow button. Okay, so we have this. What do you guys think? Background primary, which is orange, or black? Well, Jack, I know, I now I don't know what you find perfect. Orange? Black, remember, I have a little delay with the stream. And welcome back, Jack. I don't know. Orange seems like more on brand, but black seems like better fitting inside of this component. Maybe we can do like, I don't know, what's this? You know, a red, because it's not like a, oh my god, you are going to click this button and then you're gonna nuke Russia or whatever. Okay, let me style it just a little bit more so it's more like the other buttons. So like font heading. Right, and I think we need to have a little bit more. Let's say 2.5. Let's just juice it up a bit more. I think this is pretty close to what the button needs to be, right? Right. And then we also have this, and I think we need like font medium for this. Nah. Text leading. Okay, so these are the button fonts, so we can say black or we can say primary. I think orange, though it's the color of our UI. I think if it's black, is it really that obvious that is a button? I mean, here it's the contrast between orange and black that makes the difference. Now, here I don't feel it. I don't know. I think I'm going to make it orange. If there are any objections, please present them to the court right now. Let's also add hover. I should really make this a button component, but I'm just too freaking lazy. Where's the fetch more? Load more. Just want to have the hover styles of this. Shadow button. Doesn't this have a hover? Nah. Okay, then we are going to add the hover. I'd say orange too. Okay, then we're going to keep it orange. Let's say over background opacity, like, I don't know, 80. Do we have a transition? Yep, transition. Is that a little bit of a delay, which is nicer. So let's also add that to the button. Which I'm right, right? That adds a small. It's not all that big, like the delay, but transition. Yeah. So background color function QB. Yeah, 150, which is fine. So let's also add that to the navigation. Where are you? So we have rounded, then we can do this. Hey Connor, welcome to the stream. How are you doing? That's fine. Maybe I'm just gonna update this like also to like background opacity. Or maybe we just want to do it. Let's just do background color. What does background opacity do? Huh. Did I just make something up that just doesn't exist? Backdrop opacity. Text opacity. I think I made something that just doesn't simply exist. Oh. Okay. Then we're going to have a... Right? Also works. I'm good, thanks. How are you? Doing great! Almost got rid of like the most terrible flu I ever had. Nah, that's not entirely true. Not true at all. Last week I was a little bit under the weather, and the week before that as well. And now I'm pretty good. Pretty good. Pretty productive as well, man. I think like towards the end of the week, I'm really having this like this project down, the streaming schedule down, the daily updates down that I post on Dev2. So yeah, I'm getting a hang of it. Of this, like, just affiliates with all the build logs, with all the content surrounding it. Site design is really clean. Oh, thanks, man. I'm actually not a, I mean, yeah, I can say designer because I graduated as a designer, but it was never really my strong suit. The college I went to, like the program, I went more like to the front end side, coding side, and the product development side instead of like design. But I'm trying to get better at it. So we actually do some designing on stream. It just has been a while since we are currently building this. So thanks, I really appreciate the compliment. Okay, so let's see, we have to clear filters. So we can clear filter this, then we can clear filter this. And then we're going back to the homepage. Then we have to load more, which we probably also have to change, right? Load more button. How did we do this? Let's also add a hover to this. I've just started using Tailwind. It's been real good fun. Goof fun. Good or goof. Yeah, I love Tailwind. Okay, so we actually have the backend primary here. Let's also add it on the hover. Yeah, I really like Tailwind, but I must say I've used it in like a WordPress theme, and then it's just a little bit too much with all the templating. But if you can separate it out in components, the syntax isn't all that overwhelming. But then again, I don't know. I like both sides of the spectrum. You can make me perfectly happy with writing just regular CSS or SAS or Tailwind. I think for my own products, I prefer Tailwind at the moment. Pretty sure. It's complete. It reduces my bundle size. I think it's very well documented already if you like have a bigger team. I know like Nick, Star Ansible, is also on Twitch, doesn't entirely agree with me, but hey. Everybody has his own way of doing things, right? Let's say backend primary T. And now it's on here as well. And we have to add the transition. I just wish that this was a little bit more readable. One thing I've not tried is Next, still just create React app. Okay, then I can really recommend you check out Next. Because, okay, sorry for everybody watching. I'm going to answer this man's curiosity with love. If you have like, I don't know, like my index page, having access to get server-side props or get static props and server-side rendering and all kinds of stuff is really, really, really helpful in your toolbox as a front-end developer. Loading time-wise, type error. Hello, my dude. How are you doing today? So yeah, I really see like create React app is great, but I think Next.js is just a little bit of a better toolkit. I mean, you can take a more like custom approach with create React app, sure, but for me, Next.js. Chilling, just finishing up these work reports so I can work on some JavaScript practical learning. Oh, nice. Is it a big step up from Next to React? No, not really. I think their documentation is great. Just start with this. I mean, they have a whole tutorial, if I'm not mistaken. And you should really follow that. Might sound a little bit dull, but it introduces you to all the concepts. And it takes like 1 to 2 hours. Practical. What are you learning at the moment? Type editor dev. Actually, do you have a name that I can call you by? I'm not sure if I will remember because Twitch doesn't have a CRM and I have a lot of people currently. But I will do my best. Awesome, thank you. No problem at all. Type would be good. Lol. Okay, then I'm gonna tell you type. Or just buddy. I'm just going to start calling everyone buddy, and then everyone's like, okay, now I'm confused. Who are you talking to, Twan? Okay, let's see. Let's get this out because we have updated the buttons. Actually, does everything still work on mobile? That's also a great question if you're building a product. Does my thing actually work on mobile? let's do the category pets. Okay, let's select multiple. We don't have, let's say, clear filters, and this works as well. Cool, great to see that I didn't totally fuck up mobile already. Right now, the project I'm working on is a word guessing game with vanilla JavaScript. Oh, nice. Nice, nice, nice. Games are a great way to learn JavaScript. I think games are a great way to learn like any programming in general. So okay, we updated this. Okay, transition with a hover. Again, edit and transition and normalize the opacity, filter context. Okay, so if we don't omit it, we set this. Otherwise, if you hit the homepage, do this and return. Otherwise, omit the category, like stay on the category, do shallow, so don't reload the page. Cool. So it's focusing on solidifying the array concept for the array concept for loops at event listener, etc. Nice. If you want to share it with us, I'm happy to have a look at it. How are we going to reset filters at reset filters? Show reset filter button. Show reset filters button. No results. Sounds like a pretty good commit. Let's push this a baby. Push. Let me see. We can take a little break from this by watching a GitHub or by looking at a GitHub. My English sucks from time to time. A good old to-do file. I haven't seen that one in a long, long, long time. There's a work core of PDF in the repo sort of explains a bit of what needs to be done. Treehouse. Oh my god. How to approach this project. Is there like a example? Oh wait. I guess I can see it here, right? Oh no, there's actually no example. Is there example type? Like an example of like a working? Or maybe I will... I can select this. Oh my god, GitHub. I mean, I think I can just download this, do this. Open it in here, then do this, then go to correct URL. And then I'm not authenticated. Should have expected that one. Ah, no! Didn't want to close everything. Oh well, then I'm just going to have a look at your code. So, we have a little thing called an... Woo! Button. Then we have a UL. Okay, format police. Why isn't this format like nicely below each other? Oh, you didn't create the HTML, serious. Okay, format police treehouse. Why the fuck is in the... I'm gonna sue treehouse. Okay, so you're basically only taking care of, like, this. Cool. I've already mentioned it this step, nice. I think this just, like... Or mathing like HTML and like setting prettier and all that kind of fun stuff, which might be a little difficult if you're starting out and like you won't entirely understand why, but it makes a real big difference in how fast new developers pick up projects if everything's just formatted out nicely and is readable and just gives you nice tingly feelings inside your belly, like, oh, this is beautiful. Declaration array. Actually, don't you want to do this like via, instead of setting styles via an event listener? I think personally, like, I don't know if I can say it's industry standard, but in all the themes I was, we're only like setting and removing classes, and like in CSS it should take care of styling, basically separating concerns. JavaScript should only be for like functionality, and styling should be based on like adding, removing classes. My own mistake. I mean, it's not terrible because after you click on something happens, you can like follow the trail and get back to it. But personally, I would add a class. Function get random phraser. Actually, let me increase this for you all on stream. Sorry guys. Get random phrases array. Okay, so math floor. Phrases.length, that's Wait. Isn't this a bug? I think length start as at 1, right? And not at 0. I'm not sure. I should check that out. I think this can overflow like by 1, which makes your array like fucked. But I'm not sure about it. You should test it out. I mean, I'm not on hand with code. And I'm sorry, guys, for everybody watching. I'm not one of those developers who can look at code and be like, oh yeah, that's definitely a bug. I have to check things myself as well in the console or all kind of other things. I'm just a mortal. Should it be phrase length minus 1? Yeah, I think so. But check that out if I were you. Like, check phrases.length and check like if it were, yeah, because like phrases 0 should be the first index, and I think if this is like, yeah, because your phrase 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, so your phrases array will go to index 8 while phrases.length will go until 9, I think. Yeah, just jot it down. I mean, I could be wrong. Maybe it's a combination of things. Yeah, check that. Add phrase to display for each for const jar of phrases. Honest confession, I never use this. But if you do this, you can maybe you can use a map here instead of a for loop. I mean, I don't want to get into the whole performance discussion. I mean, that's more of a preference, but. So you create an element and then you append it to the text node. Yeah, hold on, that looks pretty good. And then this is what you're still working on. Cool, man. Hey, once you have it up and running, just share it with us and we can have a look. So for use affiliates, let's move on, shall we? Appreciate the looksy. Yeah, no, it's always fun. I encourage everyone, share your code. Maybe I can learn something from you. Or maybe you can learn something from me. I mean, that's the whole purpose of my whole streaming adventure. Like, building in public and growing in public. And it can work two ways. Okay, so this is actually another thingy. Okay, so update no row, completed. Show loading indicator besides filter. Since we are, like, routing and, like, removing query parameters and updating tables and setting filters, if you do like credits and like descending and you have this and you set this, you see first the filters like get set to nothing, then we have to wait a little bit and then it like navigates. So I think we have to do a little bit like maybe just a small p-sound. I mean, we can animate with little dots and make it beautiful, but fuck that, we want to launch sooner rather than later, so we are just going to add a little loading indicator. How the F I'm gonna do that? I have no clue. We will figure that out right now. What are we working with? So we have, do we have an is loading state? So if we do this and we are navigating. Ooh. Do we have something with a router that we can work with? That would be awesome. Next router. Okay, like define low is base path locals, or maybe we can use like. Oh, that could be a hack as well. Like maybe we can access the use infinite thingy. Let's see if we can use that. Like let's go to category. Or maybe even better, let's fix this on the homepage. 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 This is still not the homepage. pages, use filter, we have to use infinite, and we have to is loading. So if we pass the we can do is loading more. So then we can go to listing, and then we can go to like, it's loading more. We can wait. Go to listing. Why isn't this open listing? God damn it. I have to say that using TypeScript in a project I did over the weekend was actually way more convenient with like switching files. For some reason, VS Code just works better when you're using TypeScript, which makes sense because it gets more information about types and functions and all that kind of fun stuff, but still. Now I am wondering, do we also need it to be present here? Yep. No, actually we don't have anything for that, so we can go to pets. We can go to credits. We can do clear. Okay, so this is fast enough, so we probably don't need it here. Okay, so let's go back to the homepage. Then we only need it like, where are the clear filters? Clear the filters. Here. Okay, so we might have to do this. And then this. Loading. Huh. Okay, but now I guess that if we do like this. Okay, so loading is not shown. Because it's not is it loading more? Or am I just... Or is loading more only triggered when you actually press the button of loading more? Because I guess it's not loading more, it's just loading new data, and that could be like a whole different prop type. I mean, SWR, that library has like already proven that it's not the most logical library ever. So we might have to do a little searching. So if I do this, see, it's not sending anything. Sucks. Where is it? The old layout. Let's refresh just to be sure that we're not missing any code. So let's see. Listing. For listing, we add is loading more. Then we go to... we don't have to do anything here. We didn't change anything here, right? No, we only did it here. So we added the prop type. So probably if I'm now... It's not showing anything. That's great. Hop! Let's do a simple console log. Undefined. That's interesting to say the least. So here it's false, and here it doesn't want to be set. I should be flipping burgers. What is going on? Okay, so it's loading more. So it's actually not passed on to the... is that... No, that doesn't make sense. Because if we can get have categories here, we can sure as hell have like is loading more here, right? Because if I move this inside of the like default layout, is it still going to work? should work, right? Oops. Home false. Cool. So why the flipping flip isn't this work? So listing is loading more is false. Okay, so I made a spelling error, right? So we have listing. Listing is loading is false. Because I am a moron because I didn't edit to... Oh my god, Tvan! Sometimes I ask myself, should I be doing this? Should I be going back to school? Should I retire? I mean, I wish I could retire, but I don't have the money. Okay, so we have that set. It's loading more. Now, let's see if this actually works. I don't think so, because it's not saying loading. But if I'm now going to like load more here, it's probably... It's not even saying loading there. You see anything happening in the DOM? Like, what happens if I just... Let's see, maybe it's because... Okay, so now we have loading, right? Okay, there it was loading. But if I like reset it, it set this, it's not loading. Ah. Interesting. I'm also wondering why it says it's not loading while it actually is loading, but it's getting like a whole different set of data from another API point. Like, if I do descending, this should be set to loading. Do we see anything happening on the actual component if we do this? Maybe it's just a matter of like... So nothing happens here. Yeah, it's not loading more, I guess. Let's see if we can find anything about this in the like. No, I just see the documentation for this one. Okay, so we have use SWR infinite, so we have data. Yada yada. Infinite loading, load more button that depends data, and that returns and is loading more. Okay, reached end. Yeah, so that makes sense. It's validating. I think we have to set that one. Like, it's validating, same as use as we are, is validating. Okay, so what is validating? If a request for revalidating loan, okay. So we can pretty much like, include it, see what happens. So instead of this, we say also include this. Okay. So now we can set a class name. Flex. And then we can say this is not actually a P but a span. And do I still need a flex in that case? I still need a flex, of course. Class name. Let's say it gets an ML5. Maybe two. Okay, we can do that. We can say if is validating else. Actually, let's move this up one step. Let's say if it's validating, then we'll add the spawn, and then we can get rid of this, and we can say loading. Okay, so if it's instant, okay. Let's say text XS. Doesn't have to be all that. Okay, so this will just go to another page. We don't have anything in Archive Quest. Amazing. Now, why is it saying that it's not loading at the moment? Is that because maybe all the data is already cached? And that's why it's not saying anything? No. If is validating. That's interesting. Why did it work just now but isn't working now? Oh, that's why, because we haven't added it to the category. Okay, so is validating. So we also have to move that to the listing as well. Cumbersome, but hey. Maybe we have to want to do the data loading inside of here. So if I do it now, it says loading. Cool. Cool, 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 cool. Go to the listing again, then we have this. Hey, now this is actually an issue I noticed before. Why is this? Because aligning it to the top. So let's say align or item center, I guess. MB. Okay, then let's also add that to here. And so make this SM. XS is better. Zinc 600. Oh, yay. That's not what I wanted. 500. Should we say loading or updating? I guess it's updating, right? Again, anybody have an opinion on that? Like, if we do... Okay, so let me show you. My babies. So if we say is validating, then we want to show this. Okay, so if I update this one, cool. Now why isn't this working? Okay, let's go back to the homepage. Okay, so you see it's loading. So if we do credits, then it's loading. If we do one time, it's loading. If we do monthly, it's loading. Do one time, it's not loading because it already has the data. Should that little like status update say loading? Or should it say updating. Because while it's while it's loading the data, you can also say no, it's updating the data based on the filters. What do you guys think? Anybody? Otherwise, I will have to make an executive decision again, but I'm not sure at all. Okay, so while everybody's thinking about that, I'm just going to figure out why this is validating thingy isn't working for the categories. Is validating... Okay, let's look at... This thing is validating is false. Okay, so it's definitely working. It was just in cache. See, it's in cache. Oh, that's fast as fuck. That's actually fast as fuck. Okay, and then we can go to music. Now, that will go to another page, which is not shown at the moment, but online it will just go to another page and it will load, so we won't see that happening. Okay, so now back to the topic of whether we want to see, like... Actually, I want to move it a little bit to the left. Let's go to listing. I want to move it to the left. Let's say, is it true or like is validating? Let's just go that's false and then move it just a second. What if we move it just like a little bit more, not like just a tiny bit more to the left? 1.5 feels better. Maybe we also have to say like font medium. Nah, we're gonna keep it like this. And what font what font weight is this? Let's say semi bold. Better. It makes it a little less boldy. Makes it a little less boldy, you know. Okay. Now we can remove this. I think this is done. I think we can call this a success. Okay, so let's go through this, push it, move on to the next one. We are getting a lot of work done today, which is nice. Oh well, I have the context of like fixing the whole filtering and doing lots of magic things, which you don't have if you didn't watch the beginning of the stream where I went over it all. Don't worry, I will put it in the build log for all the people who are tuning in later, and it will also be up on YouTube. You can practically watch like the first 5 minutes of the stream back and you get a sense of what I did this morning. Or maybe better. Is this the commit I was referring to? Yeah. If you want to have a look, why am I giving myself chat rules here? If you want to have a look at like the GitHub and like the commit that was responsible for fixing the filters, which we didn't get done last Thursday, have a look. Okay, so this is done. Back to the code view. Okay, so listing we have is validating, and then down here we flex this, we flex that. Sure, ML, MB, no. Okay, cool. Item center. Then here we added is validating, which we want to have. Then is validating for here, which is cool as well. Then for the category is validating. And I guess we don't need a template string right here. So let's fix this as that as well. Okay, API programs. Cool. Show loading cater switching build results are not in cache. Cool, git push. Okay, nice. Very nice. Let's pick a new to-do. We did this and that's completed. Okay, yeah, sponsored rows. Sponsored rows. Make sure sponsor rows appear first category page. That's something I did this morning. Let me open the commit then myself to show you what we've done. We didn't have to do an awful lot, but if I go to where's my Notion file, here it is. Let's see. Okay, so one thing I did in the database was making two columns instead of one. Back. Hey Jack, welcome back. Is I made like two columns instead of one, like one for, oh, you can see it right here actually. Like, is sponsored category or is sponsored home? Because I want people who post a program to, let's say, is everything nearly finished? Yes and no. Yes, we can, in theory, I think we can launch like tomorrow or Thursday, but practically we still need to do like the whole post a program form, and while thinking of that last week, I want to automate that, because the thing is, if people post a program and they fill out the type form and they haven't paid me, you leave like a gap in between where people can still decide like, ah no, I want to pussy out, right? So I want to catch like the money as soon as people like even think of like paying me money. Like, okay, finish the form, pay me, you'll get submitted, okay, pleasure doing business, talk to you next year when you need to extend your subscription. So I was looking into MemberStack and Stripe and Chargebee, and everything is a little different. I like MemberStack at the moment, because MemberStack V2 is going to include like a React implementation, which makes it very easy for me to include like subscriptions.
This is Tyler with MemberStack.
Like, here, have a look at this.
To share what we've been working on.
Wait, let me stop my Spotify, but let's go over this, because I was pretty excited when I saw this. I mean, over the weekend I played with Superbase and authentication, which is also like that simple, like even more simple than Firebase, but this really piqued my interest, because this not only takes care of authentication, it also takes care of like payment.
At MemberStack, I have a sample Next.js project set up. I've added some code here. I've added a single method that's going to handle a sign up. And if I navigate to the actual Next.js application.
Yeah, the only thing is, I can't wait for this to get released, right?
And fill this out.
Otherwise, we'll have to post the project like indefinitely or until
this
thing comes out.
And what this is going to do is take me to a profile page, which is using an additional MemberStack function that is available. And essentially what that function...
But as you can see here, like, you basically create a try catch and sign up with email password, like plan ID. Like, this would be like the Stripe product ID, and then you're set. No, yeah, like MemberStack is out, but like this thing is still in beta, and I haven't been invited for the beta, which sucks. Please invite me. So yeah, this is in beta. I mean, I can add the regular like HTML, CSS thing, but I have to take a look. I mean, that makes it more difficult. Do you still use SCSS? I've used it in like... I think the last time I used SCSS was like last year, September. And that was for a platform that has like a million users. So if I have to use it again, yeah, I'm sure I will still use SCSS. I'm not against it. But what do you use now? Tailwind? Which is fine. And which I actually prefer at the moment. Unless it's like a really like big project. I don't know if I would want to go with Tailwind. I guess so. I do not see why not. But it will definitely be like an implementation with Tailwind with more extension to the team. Would you recommend learning raw CSS or raw CSS all the way? I mean, library, just like I'm using Next.js, I won't try to use Next.js when I don't have the basic of create React app down, for example. Maybe people will not agree with me, but actually it's so valuable to set up your own React application, to learn the ins and out of it, use state management, all that kind of fun stuff, and then you move on to Next.js because you see the value of using Next.js and you see the value of server-side static site generation or server-side rendering and all that kind of fun stuff. So the same for CSS. I would really recommend learning raw CSS, like new CSS variables, like the grid, because Tailwind is great. React Router is still a mess. React Router has always been one of those things that's like easy on the surface, but very painful if you want to do more complex things. But no, I would learn like raw CSS, definitely. Because if you learn raw CSS, you actually are, it's a breeze to use Tailwind. That's why I ditched React to Next. But no, hey, I mean, Next still uses React Router on the hood, so. Or you should try out Remix, which is actually made are they using their own router? I think it's like basically based on React Router, right? They have their whole own router. Means that package, but I think it's based. Huh. I thought this, maybe I'm thinking like versions back, but I'm pretty sure I read somewhere that's heavily inspired, or at least inspired on React Router, or maybe it was inspired on the flaws, I don't know. But still, I mean, I've worked with like Remix, which is made by the guys from React Router. Works great. I mean, I guess it's still like if we go to React Router, which version are we on right now? Because I think in the version I used, it was like version, yeah, see? Here, it's pretty much the same now as Remix, but now they made it in React Router v6. Yeah. Remix might change every version, so I don't want that to happen. I mean, I use Remix for my own site and it has been great so far. I don't know if I want to use it for any big project, although the industry is kind of moving towards it. What I like about Remix is that it relies more on good web practices rather than like abstracting everything away for you. I don't know. It has its charms. It has its place, you know. But let's see. Let's continue with the planning. Okay, sponsored rows. So that means that we inside of database file pretty much have to get the like is sponsored sort, and then we can set it to either properties. How do we call this? I mean, is sponsored home right and is sponsored category. Shit, wrong database. Or wrong Notion file. This is what I need. Is sponsored home. Okay, so is sponsored home, which is pretty much I guess it's a checkbox. Do we have any checkboxes? What's the actual developers of Notion.com? Property object. Here it is. So it's a checkbox. Have no graph with the checkbox property. Okay, so it's sponsored home. Okay, so is sponsored home. Let's just first check that one before we move on to another one. And I have to refresh this. Oh, that's because I didn't move pass it along to the listing item, right? Okay, no initial data. Is sponsored home. And we have checkbox. Okay, we don't need anything else. Okay, and so I think we need both categories because, like, both home and category because it can be both. Is sponsored category, and this will always have a value. So let's refresh. Let's see if it's still. It's not the categories one. It's the data. Okay, so this is sponsored. Okay, so this is right. So now we can pass it along to. If we go to listing. Where do I map this mother bleep? Okay, payment type, cookie period, sponsored. And I guess we can say like it's sponsored home. Yeah. How do I want to do this? Maybe I just want to set it like this way. I mean, doesn't have to be the most well thought out thing at all because this application isn't all that big. But maybe I want to set like a sponsor to three values, like false, home, or category. Then you can do everything with one prop. Huh. You know what? Let's just split it inside. Let's split it into two for now. And then we also okay. So we have that. Now we also need a way to determine when we are going to. Okay, so if we have a category, we want to render it. Otherwise, we don't want to render it. So I don't think we want to do it right here. I think we want to create a function out of this and do like a return. Is that right? Why are you complaining? Because you probably need this. Then we can say is sponsored, which is just gonna be like this. Sponsored, it's going to be equal to a function i.isSponsored. So if category, okay.
if category NN is sponsored category, return false, else return true. Cool. Return statement is not allowed here. Where? Is it because of this function? I don't understand. Oh. ¿Qué pasa? Why am I returning? Oh, shice. Render list items. Okay, cool. I'm an idiot. Formatting this guy. Let's just type it out over again. Sometimes this is just the way that works. I already see what's going wrong. I've wrapped this inside of a return, and it shouldn't be. See, sometimes I need to do a little tippy typey. Insert, you can say. Expected that, cool. Cool, 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 cool. So we have like this. Is sponsored home true, is sponsored category false. So now we should see that this one, we are on the home. So this should be sponsored true. And it is. Now, if we go to like music, it should be there as well. But then it should be like not sponsored because this is only... why is Spotify not on music? Qu'est-ce que c'est? Oh, because it's Shopify, not Spotify one. Fuck me. I always confuse the two. I think that's problem for more people. Let's see. So we have like music. Now that's based in, I guess, e-commerce or software. Is it also in the software category? I don't know. Let's have a look. See. It's not. That sucks. But hey. So it's definitely not at the top. So where is Shopify? Shopify. And now if we go here, it's like is sponsored is false. And Amazon should have an in sponsored is true. Yeah, because this, if we look at the database, is sponsored category is true. Okay, before I move on with like styling the entire thing, I'm going to do two things. Actually, three things. First, I'm going to change into a t-shirt because I'm sweating my balls off. Then I'm going to go to the toilet, and then I'm going to grab a drink. And I guess step four is move on with styling everything. So I will see you guys in like, I don't know, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, maybe even less.
I am back, baby. Okay. Let's see. Let's inner monitors. Let's stretch a little. Nice. Let's place my phone to the side. And then let's open the refreshment. Put me in a commercial right now, Sprite. Oh shit, I still had coffee. Am I going to, like, take advantage of all the caffeine that's still in that cup, or... I mean, it's gonna be cold. Caffeine addict. Let's see if this is still, like, if we can, how my face will look after this. Ah, that's nasty. That's even more nasty. Okay. Back to work. Enough banter. Back to work. Okay, so we have the sponsored rose. So now we need to style those motherfuckers. I'm actually in the mood for some like music bangers instead of this lo-fi stuff, but oh, it's the wrong thing. But then Twitch is gonna ban me, or like not ban me, but like mute all my audio. I really have to like figure out how I can side channel my music. Because I know it's possible, you can like put your music on a different track and then it won't be like exported into the video, which can prevent copyright strikes or like muted audio for that matter. Maybe I'll figure it out, because I really want to like do some techno bangers and... I don't know, maybe some metal, some rock. Okay, so we basically are going to give this an orange border. Let's go into listing items, and we have ins sponsored. So let's turn this into this. Actually, what are you guys listening to while coding? I guess 99 out of 10 times I'm just listening to nothing. I mean, that helps me focus more. But if I'm doing streams, I like to put on some lo-fi. Otherwise, I'm really having the feeling that I'm just talking to the void. I'm at least listening to something. Let's say if search. Let's give order. So let's give it nothing. Order. Board. Primary. Can't I give this a border? It should have a border now. Am I special? This is right, right? Maybe I just forgot to how to do this in Tailwind. That can very well be the case. Let's look at border. So we have border. Okay, so border 2 maybe. I guess we're also missing the other properties. Maybe image doesn't have like class name. Okay. Okay, so rounded works, but the shadow doesn't work. What if you put this on the div? Then it does work. Okay, that's cool. So I think this will be equal to like the shadow of the buttons which we used. Yep, that's right. So then let's get rid of this one. You know what? Let's just get rid of the class name entirely, because I think we can do like rounded here. And then like overflow. Hidden. Cool. Then let's turn this into template string. Then this. Nice. Okay, so how fat is that? That's just one pixel border. Ah, I might make it two. Now that I'm seeing this live. Might make it two. Can we get away with making the image like a little bit bigger? No, because the width of the column is 70.
Shoot.
Okay, so now we need this little cute label. So I guess we can make this papa relative. This papa, this parent. Then we can add a little spawn. Say sponsored. Cute. Okay, let's give this a class name. Let's say... Also, let's only show this when it's sponsored. Let's say absolute mundo text XS text white BG primary PX of one, I guess. 60. Oh, it's way smaller. Oh, we are going to run into this issue again, aren't we? Cool. That's not going to work. How are we going to do this? Because now I probably need to do like a little bit of top thing. Like placement. Do they have the X setting with like where you can say it's 50%, but you need the text and form? Oh, shite. Okay, so I guess it's bottom zero. Where are you? So absolute bottom zero. Or actually bottom minus bottom one. Is bottom two, and now this is not going to work because okay, so that sucks. So we have to get rid of this overflow hidden and place it back on. It's fine. Do I prefer it? No. Do I have an alternative? No. Okay, and then we say like left is 50, half, I guess. I guess not. Left. Do they have like a transform? Okay, no, they don't. To four. Two. If fear. Or one of two. Okay, fine with me. Yep, and now I need to have a transform. Translate minus 50%. Translate X. Yep, I need this one.
And can I put a minus in front of this? Yes. Look at these. It works. Okay, this really grinds my gears. Why the f... Okay, so this is rounded, but the border... It's not filling. Ugh. This makes me want to throw up. There is spacing. And I probably want to outset the border. Because it doesn't make sense to make the image smaller. Border style, I guess. What do we have? Border radius. Okay, border width, border style, border color. Box size. I think it's box sizing, right? It's the property again. Let me check this for just a second. Yada yada yada. I think you're stood properties over outside edge of the element. Make size outline will not change the size of the position. Side of border from okay. No, but let's be an out. Taking an out. Maybe this will also fix like. Ah! I did that close then. Why the fuck is this outline so fat? Why are you so fatty fat? I don't judge you, but still you're fat. Where's the outline? Outline color. Do I have to specify outline one? Or you have to specify outline, then outline one. Alright. Well, outline 2 might actually be what we want. Ooh, outline 3 is actually what we want. Yeah, outline 2 is what we want. Okay, so then we have this little sponsor thingy. Actually, guys, is there a way to... I don't know if anyone knows in the chat, but I've been looking for this for a long time. I don't want to zoom in on the page. I just want to use like a magnifying glass so that my DOM doesn't change, but I can still like... inspect an element from up close, you know? So I wish I could like zoom in on this right now. It's still being like 70 pixels. Because I don't know, is it like rightfully aligned? Sponsored, or is it slightly off center? I think it's centered. But I'm not 100% sure. Is there a way I can check this? It doesn't seem center. I mean, it seems like it's like... Isn't it like ML1? like 1 pixel. I think it's 2 pixels off. No, it's 1 pixel off. But that's annoying. It's only 1 pixel off. Oh, what do we have here? Oh, God, love CSS, my, why do you do this? Uh-oh. Okay, so we have this image. Why is this 68 by 68? It should be 70 by 70. Let's refresh for a second. Why exactly do I want to flex this thing? Yes, I don't want to flex this thing. Why is this height? Shit. Why? Oh, because I actually added position relative, isn't it? No, it isn't. Then why is this making my freaking thing? Okay, so we've rounded with shadow button. Or is it just now obvious because I have a shadow button? I guess that's it, right? It was always that height. But we just didn't show the shadow button, and that's why it never occurred to me. Okay, so a lot of things are going well, but what we do have right now is a little bit of a pickle with this. So if I display flex this, God, love it. Well, I can make it actually 70. I guess I can. Maybe I could fuck around with the line self. No. Yep, that's it. Cool. I knew there was a solution. Now what's this self-sender? Somebody come get her. Resetting self-sender. Oh my god. That doesn't look all that well, hey? But maybe that has something to do with this weird ass. No? Why you no work? Why is this taking the entire width? Because it's only called spawn one. Ah. We might actually want to wrap it inside of a spawn itself. Like this whole thing, because we need to separate layout with styling of the element. Okay, so let's just pass this class over. So it's relative self-center. Okay, so we want to have column spawn one inside of there. Let's remove it here. Do this. I'm still not sure why we need to flex, so I'm going to remove it. Why do we need that? No ID. Okay, so this looks better. Relative shadow button outline spawn one. Okay, now this problem is back. Now that doesn't work, which is awesome. Interesting. Line item start. I'm getting so annoyed. Sometimes I would love to just implement something and everything just works out, you know, without any bugs. Okay, so we know that this is an issue because this takes the height of the entire row, which is actually not thing. So I have to set this to self-center, I guess. Yes. Maybe. Oh. Hey. What's an email? Let me check it real quick, guys. It's which account? I'm like getting constantly bombarded with like test emails from a platform I used to work for like a couple of years ago. It's pretty funny because they are sending me like subscription codes, but I think it's for the staging environment.
But so far I've received like, I think 10 to 20 of these codes. So if anybody wants like a free access to a tool. Huh. So this works, but now on mobile it will probably not work. Okay, but what if I on mobile I say like on from Oh. Yeah, I guess this is just on the wrong. I mean, I could just set the shadow on like a spawn and then wrap that inside of the image. So like, this spawn over here. Then outline over there. Over there, then move the relative back over here. It's not working. This is annoying because everything is nested. Yeah, la 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 la. This is annoying because everything is nested. La la. Okay, we have like column. Item start. Why is this full width? I don't know. Self start. Okay, so this is taking this. This is taking. I fixed this issue like 1,000 times before. But not recently, so that's why I'm struggling with this. So yeah, so now we have one. Took my snickle. How did I do this? Okay, so this was pretty much like exactly what we want to. As soon as we hit. Okay, so this is also fine, I guess. I mean, the container is a bit fucked up, but. I mean, the container could be a little wider here. I don't know, what's the problem with this one? Let me check that first, actually. So, max width is 768. I don't care. I want to fix this first. We can do this. But then again, that feels a little cumbersome or like not that way. But hey, do we mind? Do we actually mind? I guess not. Okay, so here everything looks great. Here everything looks okay. I might actually want to... Okay, so... Okay, this... So yeah, that's why I added the flex column. From medium on, because we also want to have medium from justify center. Oh well, I'm not gonna bother by that. Oh, what's the problem now? You can stay, I don't care. It still works right. Okay, so I guess now we have sponsored rows. I mean, this is the category page. Then we have a home page. And that works as well. So hey, winning! We might actually want to update this just a bit more. Ah, that's too much. I think this is fine. I think this is fine. So the only thing that remains is this. In mean, I can use flex and then align center. Maybe there's a... Now the element center is... know what is going wrong. I guess we're there, guys. So let's review this, see if we made any mistakes, and then we can push this. Program stills works like a charm. Alrighty then. Okay, so for the sponsored shit, we have done this, which is what we want. Then for the list items, we determine if it's sponsored. So we don't actually have to do that logic inside of here. Say if it's sponsored home, if it's not sponsored home, it's not. It's not like for the category false. If we have a category, we know that we are on the category page. So we say, okay, and if it's then sponsored category, still false. Otherwise, we know, okay, your home page where you need to be true are on the category page where you need to be true. So then you're sponsored. Then you get a little badge of honor and you get pushed to the top of the list. So yes, this is fine. Please stage yourself. So is sponsored. We added that. We added class name rounded here. Box shadow there. I guess, do we still need to round it rounded? Maybe that was a little mistake on my side. Yeah, we need to round it rounded. Yep. Okay, not too. It's not the end of the world. I wish I could do better, but because we have an overflow, I said no. Okay, with relative flex, self center outline, cool. Okay, this all looks fine. Sponsor Rose. Sponsor. Simply sponsored row styling. To push that, it's available to self and I. Okay, next on the list.
Where are you? Let's see. Sponsored rose is done. So now people can pay me money for sponsored rose. Okay, so we have an about page, we have a 404 page, we have a post a program page, and we have still have to do this implement SEO. We have to also make a launch plan. But I guess we'll first do a beta launch of some sort, so that all you guys can like play around with it, like find bugs, send me like bug reports, or just place your bugs in chat. And then once we catched all of the things, we can do a product hunt launch and a hacker news launch and set up a newsletter and all that kind of fun stuff. So what's the most important thing for now? I guess we can set up an about page and a 404 page, so we can focus on the post to program page tomorrow, or like the SEO. Let's just start with a simple 404 page, shall we? Now, how do you do this again in like custom error page? Like 404, okay, so that's pretty straightforward. Let's collab everything, let's go to pages, let's say 4.js, export default. Actually, portal for of course that can be a number. Let's just out. The default layout has a title, not found Reno. This is not the page you're looking for. Okay, so if we now go to a category that doesn't exist, like my love life. We misspelled this because this needs to be capitalized, of course. Not found Reno. Okay, that's great. But I might want to actually, what do I want for a 404 page? Do I want to make a joke, or do I just want to update the header? Or maybe I want to make a whole different page for this one. Okay. So let's see. We have a nav. We have an index. So how is the nav handled inside of the layout? So let's do that. Let's import the nav and let's just say nav. I don't think we have to give anything to the nav, just like okay, that's great. Which also makes me wonder if I need a dark variant of the navigation. How do I want to do this? Actually, let's open Figma. I guess that's like the easiest way to visualize and like prototype quickly. Right. So which page is the most empty? I guess this one. So let's create a error page. Error page. Beep, boop, beep, something went wrong. Maybe we can use a robot emoji or just to be edgy.
16 does 24.
What else can we show on this page? What else can we show on a 404 page? What can we make a joke? Like, would it hurt to embed a YouTube video? What would be a fun YouTube video to?
For a double hip replacement.
Eh, doesn't work that well. You know what? Let's first implement this and then we'll take it from there, I guess. Let's grab the default layout. I think that's fine, I guess. Or default. Capitalize default. Default lay. Sorry. Sometimes VS Code annoys the living hell out of me. So let's do default layout. Then let's grab this text like bleep bloop bleep. Bleepity bleep bloop. Title is this without this. Bleep bloop beep boop beep. Something went wrong. Okay, cool. And then we want to include a button here, so let's add a button. Text is back. Go back home. Home. Slash. So let's do this like sucker. A button text and a button link. Else it's not a category. It's just a button. So we have to import link from Next.js. Can I just do this? No, of course not, because I haven't used TypeScript. Link. Cool. Link 8, and then we can this, then we can move it here, and we can say button link, button text, back home, excuse me, what's going on? Oh yeah. We can also just do like button, and inside of here we can do like button, we can make it an object. This is better. Title like and then we of course give it double bracket treatment. Then we can say but if button and button dot link, and then here say text, and now this will definitely work. Then I have to go to another page that's not found. Dollars that won't definitely not be found. Now why are you not find my sweetie tits. Hey, red says a find, but that's because button text and it needs to be button.title. Cool. Thank you, sugar tits. Then we can add a class name to this little precious mama. Say we add 26. I guess. Okay, let's just like 1.5, which is 8. No, it's not entirely true. Yeah, that is entirely true. Because like one REM is 16 pixels, and it's not entirely. It's like 16 plus 8, which is 1.5. REM, which is 6. Block. And I guess I want to intent over here. So let's say title styles, because I'm more a sucker for margin bottoms than I am for tops. So we read document bottom, so it doesn't make sense to give them one and top unless it's absolutely necessary. Or unless I don't think of my own principles and I just screw up. Okay, so let's start this sucker. Okay, so we have background black block, no black. Text white, x4, 2, sleepy white, I guess. Let's make this a little bigger, then it's rounded, and it has a shadow of button. And now that it has a shadow of button, we can also say that is text heading, and it's like I'm making a mistake, it's font heading, then it's bold, and then for the hover we say background of black Looney is like transition, so we have a nice effect, and we can say like 80 was a little too much for my liking. It can be a little bit more. So that means that also the navigation, in my opinion, let's search for 80 and let's change it to /90. Yes, I want to replace it, so 90 better, more subtle, still obvious. So beep boop beep, something went wrong. What went wrong? I don't have my millions of dollars, so go back home. And we get here. Now if I go to another page that doesn't exist, like love life, and we also have like beep boop beep, something went wrong. Cool. Yeah, I'm still like not liking the white space here. I want to include some kind of I want to include some kind of media. I don't know. Does somebody have any ideas in chat what we can show there? What kind of video? I mean, or a meme or a GIF. I don't know. Just send me memes. I want to see memes. As long as it's not porn, I'm fine with it. Or anything else illegal on Twitch. I trust you guys. In the meantime, just drop it in chat because I have to pee really bad. Be right back.
Thank you.
I am back. No, no memes? Oh my god, okay. Nobody's really chatty today. Oh well, I guess it's a Tuesday. People are working, people are co-working. That's fine as well. Only love, little smooch for you. Hopefully you are doing some great work today. Which means that I need to figure this out myself. Damn, no memes. No memes. No memes. Why are there no memes? Not found meme. I'm coding, so no memes for me right now. Okay. You know what? I will just leave this open. We can always, you know what? I will add it to my to-do list. This is something we can do before launch. So let's say we have 4, think of design, implement 4, 4 page. Let's say add meme to 4, 4 page. Fine with me. So beep boop beep, something went wrong. Go back. That works. Oh, if I go to family. Oh, this is confusing. Based on these criteria, if you want to be the first speech program. Yeah, okay, we are going to have to remove that. Because if categories don't have any... I mean, no. No, 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 no. I will have to make a check. Exclude any categories that don't have any rows. A lot of categories don't have, some of the categories don't have any rows. We shouldn't show them in the drop down if that's the case. Actually, Jack, what are you working on today? Is it are you building a SaaS? Are you like building a money machine? Okay, add me to 404 page, so I guess we can push this. So if I go again to the thing that's not found, which is my love life, I can shrink this down and it looks fine. Maybe the button is a little bit big, but hey. Still looks good. It looks good. It looks okay. A concept website from a design. Ooh, tell me more. I'll show you when I host it. Nice. Now you piqued my interest. Okay, let's see.
Let's push this sucker. Okay, so button text can be like be gone, spawn of Satan. Okay, we had to do that, so this is fine. And we had to update the... Okay, so that's only that. That's also the, I guess, I'm right. Yeah, the opacity of the button. And we added the 4-4 page, which is default layout. And we don't need to do anything else. Edit basic. Or 4-4 page. Behance. Ooh. Just to practice my tailwind skills. Nice. Are you actually going to... Okay, are you going to make these all like individual images? Oh, where is it? Oh, you're just going to do main page. Oh, sorry. Oh, I thought this was the header. I'm an idiot. Excuse me. Oh, I like this design. If you really want to be an MVP and like impress people, you could like make these like hover on the page, and when you move your mouse, they like move a little bit. Makes the page feel more alive. Well, micro interactions, they actually do work. You know what? This actually looks quite similar to a website Ico that like years ago now, four? Like this one. Well, no, it doesn't look the same, but it's like in the same region of design, I guess. Martijn. I hate clients. Let me just place like a big giant text. Ugh. Gonna do that something like that. Yeah, this is exactemundo what I meant. These kind of mindcore interactions work. It just gives some site a little bit more personality. Oh, it's... Nice! Okay, let's see. What else do we need to do today? I'll host it and show. Yeah. I'm interested. Actually, I think I'm gonna... okay, so we did that. You know what? Let's just set up the route for the about page. And let's set up the route for the post program page. And then I'm going to do some just chatting. Or we are going to do something else on stream for a little bit. Actually, I might... Only started yesterday. Oh, yeah, no problem, man. I mean, you have to start somewhere. Do I want to set up the routes? Yeah, I might as well. I mean, I can set up the route for the about page and then finish that tomorrow. Alongside with the basic template for the... what's it called again? The add program page. But I definitely want to get a long walk in today. Because my weight loss has kind of flatlined and that sucks. So I need to put in more work and more exercise. Or I need to put in more exercise, which equals more work. Okay, so that's pretty much this page. Then we have to think of content for that. Okay, let's set up. Ah, no! Oh my god. When you accidentally press a button and everything goes away. About export option. about, which doesn't take anything, which doesn't take anything. And we can return again the default layout. Default layout, and should have capitalized these file names, but that's my bad. Okay, so with default layout, I guess we can do this. So if I now, it isn't added to the navigation. Naughty, naughty. About page. So if I save this and we say title is, what was it? Connecting creators and affiliates. Programs to monetize. Sure. Okay, so this is still that. Okay, connecting creators and affiliates to monetize. I guess this is better. Connecting creators and affiliate programs. Connecting creators with programs. I think I want to make it a relic. I see a GitHub link. And I just dropped frames. No, I didn't. GitHub.com. Ah. I've made this. Hey, look. It's a little Jack. Hello, Jack. Hey, Next.js. Nice. Okay. Let's see. If you want to be a real MVP, move this inside of a source folder. Like, you can't move the public inside of a source folder, but I think it's a little bit more clear. But hey, you do you. And if you do that, don't forget to update these two .source/pages. Did you use the Next.js with Tailwind template? Nope, just that one. All right. Oh, Revolut, nice. So you're basically like duplicating pages now to get more familiar with frontend. Hey, this looks great already, man. You have like three more you want to do? Yeah, I think this already looks. Okay, why is it Z40 and not C10? I mean, I'm definitely not going to roast your front end. I think, I don't know, there's just something about great design that always makes you be like, wow. I wish I would have made this. It works so well. Like these background colors with these images, it's clear. Nice. Am I retarded? Where's the layout? Oh, here's the layout. Cool, 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 cool. Okay, so here's the thing. Animation will come from, yeah. Try to refrain from using background images because the browser doesn't really like that. And SEO also, you always want to use image tags if you are rendering an image. I mean, if you have a background, if it's really a background image, yeah, you can get away. Like, this could well be a background image, but I guess I also made an image. But I guess if it's already a div, just wrap an image inside of a div with next image, which will also introduce you to next image and its API. And then you can use like object fit to get what you want. But then again, I'm not going to be nitpicky on like an example, like a still work in progress thing. Yeah, I'll change it. Hey, it's only if you want a baby. It's just some a little nugget. Of 20 wisdom, I don't know. Okay, let's see. We basically want to include like the content box here. Let's fill that with the lorem ipsum, so that I can step away from my computer and work on the actual copy, because I still have no effing clue what I'm going to include on the about page. Like, hello, my name is Use Affiliates. Please post the program and make me money. Let's take this. I think this was all wrapped inside the listing, right? Container, so listing. I mean, let's grab this and don't worry about like that we are duplicating ourselves. I have to reply to one quick message. Just a second. Okay, fixed that. So let's see, if we place an H1 in here, let's say hello, let's make that a class. I don't know, text.exl. Probably have to give this like an inner container of some sort. Or we can give this a grid. I think a grid is better, like default grids. I guess that was our class name, right? Grid default, excuse me. We can save it here and we can say like full spawn on how many columns did we throw this? 8. Spawn 8. And Then we can also set a call start. Call starts 3 because it starts on 3. And if I'm not mistaken, this will be absolutely wonderful. We can add Solorum Ipsum in here. And we can add another. We can add like an. Oh, maybe this has to be an H2, right? H2. And we can do like an MB02. Capitalize it. And we can say like text font heading. And then we can do this in header example. That's fine. I don't know, let's just duplicate this. And then let's say that this also gets like a class name of, I don't know, MB8, like double the money. And then I'm already seeing that we, instead of like only a padding top, we need like, let's make this let's make this a PP. Nice. Actually, maybe we can make this a little bit bigger. Yeah. It's cool. We can do this on 6. Ah, that's too narrow. Okay, so let's say that this is from MD on. And that otherwise it's called spawn 12. Okay, so we need a BX of 4, BX of 8. That's too much. BX of 6. That's fine. Okay, so this is pretty much a decent page for the about, I guess. Now the only thing left is actually writing the content. Hey, why does this feel smaller? Wait. Why is this only stretching? So this starts on 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, I know, but why is the... Oh, that's because of the word. If I remove that word, it's going to be fine, right? Volupatatibus. Nice. Never heard of it. Fuck off. Okay, cool. Well, this is all coming along nicely. So I think we can pretty much copy paste this and also already set up like the... Ooh, how do I want to do this? Do I want to create a folder or not? You know what? Let's just set up a page and then once I get to the actual subscriptions, we can move on. Because I'm still not sure. I'm still on the edge of doing a type form, but then again, you might want to do subscriptions, because if you have subscriptions, I don't have to do anything about it. This can run itself. I can lay on the beach, drink pina coladas, and do some marketing. I mean, that would be the ideal case, but we all know that this is an example project, an example SaaS, and if you'd like to make money, disclaimer, don't try this shit at all. Let's say, submit. Let's call this submit. Is there any better way to name this? I don't know. Let's call it submit. Let's call it submit. And then we can say, oh fuck, why did I close Figma? Back. I'm actually already working on like the next series that we are going to do. Or like next series that we are going to do. I'm already working on the next thing. And I'm still like pretty much in a phase where I'm like exploring if it's even possible and how it would work because of a couple of limitations that I came across. And I'm pretty sure that's going to be awesome. So let's say we go to submit. Connect creators. That's not. Oh, wait. Back up. Beep, 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 beep. That needs to go into title. And then here we can, oh shice. Oh, we have to update the, I might give the title a width for medium. Because I guess this can be 10, right? Or like, it doesn't have to be 10, but maybe 9. Oh, that also looks shitty. Let's just keep it this way until we like get to that. So then we can also do the nav, and we can say this goes to slash submit post program. Okay, so now we have everything set up. So did we forget anything like functionality wise? Of course we have to do the about page and the post program page. That's obvious. Now people can filter, people can go to programs. Like I might actually want to write a crawler that checks all the programs if they're still working, a Chrome that I can run like every day so that I can like depublish or unpublish, I guess, like unpublish pages that are not working or that are down, so that I don't confuse users. And so that, I mean, if a user hits like 3 broken links in a row, or even 2 in a row, or maybe even 1, I think they're already kind of put off by the project and think, oh, this database is out of date. Oh, maybe we have to include a little updated no, because if I don't update the database for like a month, people watch that and see, hey, this database has been updated only last month. Oh, it shouldn't be. It would never be up to date. A lot to think about, but I think we are pretty close because this works. The main functionality works. The only thing left is like content and yeah, so the only thing left is content. One little fix with the categories, so we filter out all the categories that don't have any rows. Can I do that right now? Actually, is that an easy fix? Because I know that I do this right here. So what do I get? I don't think we actually know what's inside of here. I think I need to implement a bit more logic before that works. Or I have to just remove the categories from the database altogether, which makes a little bit more sense. And then write them down, jot them down somewhere, and then once I add a program, I can do it that way. Like once I have an item for the category, but still. I might not even need to work on that because I'm still building the database myself. Or maybe I'm going to hire someone to do the work. I don't know.
I mean, I want to bootstrap this as much as possible, and like without spending too much money, because I'm already spending a lot of time. But hey, I'm meeting you guys, so it's for the cause. Anywho, I think if nobody has any questions, then I'm going. I need to go to the store. Need to get some dinner. Also need to get in a walk. Burn some calories, baby. I think it was a pretty fruitful day. Fix the filters. We set up the pages. We what more did we do? We actually reviewed a couple of code bases. So my plan for tomorrow is to, I guess, set up the about page, come up with the content, fix the DB, and then Thursday we can, I think, do the whole sign-up process. And maybe Thursday, if the sign-up, so like the poster program is not finished yet, we can at least do a little beta check with everyone in chat. Like, I can push it to Vercel, and we do like a massive testing thing. Like, everybody can get their phone and their laptops, and can go crazy, and can submit bugs. Which will probably drive me freaking insane, having a lot of like, oh, it doesn't work on this small screen. Oh, it doesn't work on my Apple Watch. But hey, it's all for the good cause. And then we also are going to think about marketing, for which I might actually need to bring in some expertise for someone. But I'm still thinking about who the fuck am I going to call for that. Anyway, if you're not, if you have not followed me yet, now's your chance to leave a follow, which I will actually notice. I had a lovely day. We put in some good work. And I will check you guys tomorrow around the same time, 2 o'clock in the afternoon for me, Amsterdam time, until 5, half past 6. So, have a great morning, afternoon, or evening, and little smooch for everyone. Mwah. And I will see ya, Jack.